Well, tomorrow, survivors of the Sikh Temple shooting will head to D.C. 12 News' Terry Sater is live in Oak Creek tonight. And Terry, this trip was already planned, but now it's taking on a whole new meaning.
Well, this is where a half dozen people died in August of last year, and the son of a temple victim will lobby lawmakers in D.C. for stricter background checks for gun buyers. And he says today's tragedy makes his mission that much more important.
A typical Monday morning rush hour in Washington turned into chaos. Officials said Aaron Alexis, a 34-year-old former Navy reservist, made his.
Again, he will lobby for stricter background checks for gun buyers, and he says what happened today is making his mission even that much more important.
When you hear about things like this, it puts you right back at that first square.
Amardeep Kalika's father died in Wisconsin's Sikh Temple shooting, and news of the Navy Yard gunfire immediately led to a question.
You're like, how can this keep happening? This is now recurring, and it shouldn't be. And there's a lot of problems that we have to deal with as a country.
Whenever there's a mass shooting, wherever it happens, for those who lived through what happened here at the Sikh Temple in Oak Creek in the summer of last year, the shock, the grief, returned.
Those emotions have led Amardeep to action. He's flying to D.C. Tuesday to join loved ones of Sandy Hook school shooting victims to talk to lawmakers, in part about tougher background checks for gun buyers.
What I'm going to talk to legislators about specifically is there's going to continue to be a next time until we stop it.
Amardeep will point to his series of deadly shootings this summer in Milwaukee when he asks for funding new ways to stop youth violence, and continue to wonder why people open fire, like at the Navy Yard.
Like, the why is so difficult to answer, it dies with the person. And this guy was killed on site, just like what happened at the temple. But the how is super easy. The how is he had weapons.
Amardeep says he's open to reaching out to the families of Navy Yard shooting victims, but he says, as in the case of Sandy Hook, he's going to give them a lot of time and space and only go if he's asked. Live in Oak Creek, Terry Sater, WISN 12 News.